Hi friends, welcome to another FP Live session with Pinnacle Ortho Center Hospital. I am Dr. Sandeep Vaidya, pediatric orthopedic surgeon, and today we are going to discuss the topic that we have chosen for discussion is physical activity for kids or physical fitness for kids in the times of the COVID pandemic. Now, there are three main issues that I would like to touch upon in this talk. Number one is regarding the physical exercises for our children. So if we look at the international guidelines as well as the guidelines issued by WHO, it is recommended that all children between the ages of 3 and 18 years should have physical activity at least for a period of 60 minutes per day, out of which 50 minutes should be of vigorous physical activity. So what do we mean by vigorous physical activities? So vigorous physical activities are those in which we break a sweat. For example, running, swimming, play activities, all these things. However, the problem is that with the COVID pandemic, our children are now confined to the homes and external outdoor physical activities are almost nil. So how do we solve this problem? So as we know that we have to adapt to the existing situation, and therefore there are various things that you can do. There are online physical exercise sessions available. There are online Zumba sessions available, dance sessions available. Even there are online soccer teaching programs. So what you can do is you can enroll your children for these, and they can be done in a limited space. So even within the space constraints of your home, these sessions can be done. Additionally, it would be helpful if your child can do these sessions, these online sessions, with the group of friends, so that not only it helps to promote the physical activity, but also it helps to promote the psychological well-being of the child in this age of social distancing. Now you would be surprised to know that it is not just the older children, but even the children who are not yet of walking age who require physical exercises. In fact, it is the recommendation of the American Academy of Pediatricians that children who are pre-walking age, that is who have not yet started walking, should have physical exercises for at least 30 minutes per day. So how do we provide physical exercises for children who are not yet walking? So the simple thing that is to be done is that they are to be given a tummy time, which means they are going to be laid on their tummies and made to do activities like reaching out for toys or pulling up to standing position in order to give them physical exercises. So that was about the physical exercises. The second important point that I want to touch upon is correct sitting posture. Why I am talking about this? Because most of the students or most of the children today are attending online school, which means in effect that they are sitting in front of the computer screen for a period of at least 3 to 4 hours per day. And if they don't maintain a correct sitting posture in front of the computer, then they are going to land up with back and neck problems over a period of time. So what is a correct sitting posture? So number one, the first thing that is involved in a correct sitting posture is that you should sit upright with a straight back and a straight head, and the back should be supported on the backrest of the chair. So that is the first prerequisite of correct sitting posture. Secondly, the computer screen, the upper level of the computer screen should be at the eye level of the child. So adjust the height of your computer screen such that it is at the eye level of your child. Thirdly, the chair on which the child is sitting should have an armrest on both sides, so that with the elbows folded, the child can rest the forearms on the armrest. Fourth point, the mouse and the keyboard of the computer should be within easy reach of the child, so that the child does not have to slouch forward or bend forwards in order to reach out for these. And last, the height of the chair should be such that when the child is seated on the chair, the feet should be flat on the ground, or the feet should be supported by the floor. So these are a few basic tips which you can take care of while choosing a correct chair for your child, especially when he's sitting in front of the computer screen for long hours. Now that was about the sitting posture. The third and the last point that I would like to press upon is dietary habits in order to maintain good bone health in the children. So as you know, calcium and vitamin D are the two most important components of our diet which are responsible for maintaining the bone health. Let's discuss both of these one by one. First, vitamin D. So the daily requirement of vitamin D for a child is between 1000 to 2000 international units. Now, the dietary sources of vitamin D are scarce. So for non-vegetarians, they can receive vitamin D through fatty fish, and for vegetarians, they can receive vitamin D through mushrooms. However, these are not enough to satisfy the dietary requirement per day. The most important source of vitamin D, the natural source of vitamin D, is sunlight. So when we go in the sunlight, what happens is that the ultraviolet rays of the sunlight, they fall on the skin and they convert a form of cholesterol called 7-dehydrocholesterol into vitamin D. However, with the COVID pandemic, with the lockdown and the outdoor activity being restricted, exposure to sunlight has become very less, and it is not enough to satisfy our daily requirement of vitamin D. Therefore, in this situation, I would recommend that every child should receive vitamin D supplements. These vitamin D supplements are commercially available in the form of syrups, in the form of sachet, in the form of tablets. They can be taken. The dose can be a daily dose, it can be a weekly dose, or it can be a monthly dose. To know the correct dose of vitamin D for your child, it would be best to contact your local doctor or your local pediatrician, who can give the dose in the correct form and in the correct duration. Now, that was about vitamin D. What about calcium? Unlike vitamin D, calcium is readily available from multiple dietary sources. Milk and milk products are the best source of calcium. 1 ml of milk gives approximately 1 milligram of calcium. Our daily requirement, or the daily requirement of a child of calcium, is around 1000 to 1200 milligrams. Apart from milk, other dietary sources of vitamin D are, calcium, are green leafy vegetables, fruits, mainly dry fruits, till and ragi. So, if your child is consuming these products in adequate quantity, there is no need to add any additional supplement for calcium requirement. However, if you feel that your child is not consuming these food items in the requisite amounts, then it would be best to give them calcium supplements along with vitamin D supplements in order to satisfy his daily requirement of about 1000 to 1200 milligram of calcium. So friends, this was in brief what I have spoken in the last 5 to 6 minutes is about for the physical activity. It is important to maintain a healthy level of physical exercises every day, at least about 1 hour every day. Number two, maintain a correct sitting posture when they are attending their online school. Number three, maintain a good healthy diet and definitely give daily supplements of vitamin D, and if falling short of calcium, even supplements of calcium. Thank you very much for attending this session. If you have any queries, please drop these queries in the comment section of this video, and we will get back to you soon. Thank you so much for joining us. Bye.